So now we discussed about the concept of timers. So at least I think you are clear with the concept. Now we will discuss about serial communication. Okay. So what is serial communication? What is serial communication? Communicating data serially. That is serial communication. So what type of communication microcontroller is supporting? Serial communication, that is UART. Okay, we will discuss about it. So before going to discuss in detail about serial communication, first we will begin with types of communication. What are the types of communication? Serial communication and parallel communication. Okay, see the difference between serial communication and parallel communication. Serial communication means one by one. Parallel means simultaneously, parallel data. See the difference. This diagram clearly explains the difference between serial communication and parallel communication. Okay, how many types of communications are there other than this? Types of serial communication: simplex, half duplex and full duplex. You heard about this? Yes. Okay. What is simplex? One-way communication. Simplex is one-way communication. Half duplex means you can communicate from transmitter to receiver, receiver to transmitter, but not simultaneously. Coming to full duplex, parallel communication. We are used to that now. Telephone example is the best example for full duplex communication. Anybody can give the example for half duplex and simplex? Walkie talkie for half duplex. Okay, what about simplex? Simplex means one way communication. Any example? FM. Oh. Any other example? Which? Television. That is not that. I am asking about the communication. See, telephone, I am talking parallel, you can talk two way. And walkie-talkie, first I will convey the message, after some delay again I will get the message. Means transmission and receiving is going on but not parallel, not simultaneously. Printer is the best example for simplex. Understand? One-way communication, right? Printer is a better example. So many are there. So it's like to make you understand. I think printer you understand. This is simplex. So now, before going, now we will begin with actual serial communication, which is related to 8051 microcontroller. 8051 microcontroller supports serial communication, nothing but UART, Universal Asynchronous Reception and Transmission. Already I told you in the previous class that asynchronous communication means 8 bits of data, which includes 2 more bits, start bit and stop bit. Totally 10 bits we can transfer. Out of 10 bits, 8 bits are the actual data which we want to transmit from source to destination. And start bit is always low and stop bit is always high. Understand? This is nothing but UART, asynchronous communication. And what are the pins associated with this serial communication? Two pins are there. What are those two pins? TXD and RXD. TXD stands for transmit of data and RXD stands for receive of data, reception of data. And these two pins are in which port? Can you? We have discussed about the pin description of 8051 microcontroller. P3. Okay, have you remembered which pin it is associated with? P3 0 and P3 1. P30 and P31. See here, these are the two pins. One pin is for transmission of data and another pin is for reception of data. Understand? And this is associated with port 3, 0 pin and first pin. Okay. Next, these pins are TTL compatible and hence they require a light driver to make them RS232 compatible. Have you know? I think best example serial communication RS232. You know about RS232? You have performed the practicals, right? You didn't use RS232. It's a serial communication. See, here we are saying that microcontroller supports UART, asynchronous communication. And the best example of serial com, we are using RS232. Recommended standard 232. What is it? You didn't use in the practical. Without RS232 you have performed. Okay. You didn't interface the gate. Okay. It is DB9 connector, we will call it as. So we will discuss it later, then why to divert it again. Okay. RS232, we will discuss it later. We will call it as a DB9 connector. Okay. Next, MAX232 chip is one such line driver in use. Serial communication is controlled by another 8-bit register called SCON register. What is the SCON register? Serial control register. The completely microcontroller, the serial communication is controlled by SCON register, and size of this SCON register is 8-bit. See, this is the way we will interface. Actually, RS232 is there, DB9 connector, MAX232 is there, microcontroller. Microcontroller contains two pins which is associated to serial communication. One is TXD and another one is RXD. See, TXD is in port 3 first pin and RXD is in port 3 0 pin. See, here we are giving connecting to MAX232 and to RS232. Still you didn't perform it in the practical. So first we have to discuss what is the concept of MAX232 and what is the concept of RS232. Then it will be much better that you will be comfortable and how to do the interfacing part. So we will study about SCON register. So complete serial communication of 8051 microcontroller is controlled by SCON register, and size of this SCON register is 8-bit. Please, this is very important. Without this, you will not understand the coding part. So what are those 8 bits? See, what is the first bit? Please tell me. Here we will call it as 0 to 7. 0 to 7, total 8 bits. So what is the 0th bit here? RI. RI. What is the full form of that? Receiver interrupt. Receiver interrupt. What is the another bit? TI. TI stands for transmit interrupt. TB8 and RB8 are reserved for future purpose. Another bit is REN. Reception enable. Another bit, and three modes of operation. SM2, SM1 and SM0. And here we are not going to use SM2, that is reserved for future purpose. Only we are going to use two modes, SM0 and SM1. Clear? Out of 8 bits which we are reserved for future purpose, TB8, RB8 we are not using, as well as SM2 we are not using. It is reserved for future purpose. Now we will discuss about the remaining bits. Okay, what is RI? TAN RI. So here microcontroller, how much data we can transmit at a time? We can transmit, what is the size of the data bus? 8 bit. We can transmit 8 bits of data at a time. Understand? And size of the data, and as per asynchronous, it is supporting, means asynchronous communication means 8 bits of data which includes one stop bit and start bit. Understand? Okay, here when this RI and TI will enable and disable? Anyone? RI means receiver interrupt. I stands for interrupt. TI means transmit interrupt. If TI is equals to 1, means what is the meaning? If TI is equals to 1, means what is the meaning? No, no. Transmit interrupt and receive interrupt. Complete our communication, transmission of data, reception of data, and whether our data is transmitted, transmission is done successfully or not, everything we will analyze with the help of TI and RI. See, TI is equals to 1. First we will transmit 8 bits of data, asynchronous communication, am I correct? So from source to destination, means transmitter to receiver. Once the 8 bits of, while transferring, once the data transmission starts, the TI is equal to 0. Means what is the meaning if TI is equal to 0 means? The data transfer is going on. The data transfer is going on. RA is equals to 1 means? RA is equal to 0 means? Reception is serial, no? You are sending 1 bit like that. We can transfer 1 byte of data. Am I correct? If TI is equal to 0, RA is equal to 0 means even reception is going on. If TI is equals to 1 means what is the meaning? First byte transfer of data is completed. Now I am ready to transfer the next set of data. Understand? If TI raises the interrupt means what is the meaning? Previous data transfer was done successfully. Now I am ready to accept. Means now I am ready to transfer the next set of data. Same way, if RA is equals to 1 means reception of the previous set of the data was done successfully. Now I am ready to receive the another set of data. Understand? So before doing the transmission and reception, we have to check the status of TI and RA. Understand? If TI is equals to 1, then only we can start transferring the data. If TI is equal to 0 means meaning is already data transfer is in process. Any confusion? Clear? Because without this, you will not understand the code. So, if you have any confusion, please ask. Next, RB8 and TB8. By default, we have to make it 0 because it is reserved and defined. It is reserved for future purpose. Next, REN. First of all, communication. So, serial communication. First of all, if you want to do the data transfer and reception, you have to enable that bit. Means REN bit is equals to 1. You have to activate that pin. Clear? Next, SM2 is reserved for future purpose. So by default here we will make it 0. Next, SM01, SM1. Two modes we are going to use. Two modes means again four possible combinations. 00, 01, 1011. Better I'll show you the help of CDM. Two modes of operation. 00, 01. Two modes means four possible combinations. 00, 01, 101, 11. 00 means serial mode 0. 01 means 8-bit data which includes start bit and stop bit. So here microcontroller is supporting asynchronous communication. Asynchronous communication means 8-bit of data which includes start and stop it. Understand? So which mode we will operate? 01. Which mode we will operate with? 01. Means mode 1 operation we will prefer in with respect to 8051 microcontroller. Any confusion now? You understand the SCON register? You want me to repeat again? Yes or no? Yes? Okay. Now see here, what 8 bits are there? So what are those 8 bits? Receiver interrupt. Do you understand the concept of receiver interrupt? It is 1 means it is ready to accept the data. 0 means already reception is in process. TI is equal to 0 means already the transmission of data is going on. And TI is equals to 1 means it is ready to accept to transfer the next set of data. And remaining 2 bits are undefined. And REN you have to make it high. Then SM2 is reserved for future purpose, so make it 0. And what about SM0 and SM1? Two modes means four possible combinations. 00, 01, 101, 11. That I have showed you. So which mode we will prefer? We will prefer mode 1 because it supports asynchronous communication, which is nothing but 8 bits of data which includes start and stop it. So now what are the values we have to load? Tell me here. SCON, which values we have to load if you want to perform serial communication? 0, 1, SM to 0, REN 1, TBA 0, RBA 0, TI. We are starting the data transmission. 0, RI 0. Is it correct? Is it correct? Move SCOM comma hash represents immediate data 50H. What is 50H? H stands for hexadecimal. 50H means what is the value of 5? 01 01 01 01 01 00 00. Is it correct? You please check it. Is it correct? 0, SM0 is 0, SM1 is 1, means here mode 1 operation we are preferring, am I correct? Mode 1 operation means UART communication, am I correct? Which is supported by 8051 microcontroller. Okay, next. SM2 we are not using, it is reserved for future purpose, so I am making it as 0. REN, high. TB8 and RB8, 0. TI and RA, 0. Means we started communicating data and receiver started receiving the data. Means transmission is going on. Any confusion? You understand why we have loaded the value 50H into SCON? Say yes or no?
Yes.
So if you want to write a program, you have to remember all these things. And you should be very clear with the concept. Blindly you cannot mugger. If you miss the sequence also, your entire program will be incorrect. You cannot miss the sequence. Understand? Any confusion? Okay. I'll explain. After this, once we complete the concepts of serial communication, then with the help of this program, you will be clear how to use timer concept as well as serial communication with one program. Then you can write any program in your own related to this. Can I move to another? You know the instructions, set and clear. SCON is bit addressable or not? Is it bit addressable? No. It is not bit addressable. See, if you want, say whatever the concept I have explained, transmit interrupt. Means when 8051 finishes the transfer of 8-bit character, it raises the TI flag to indicate that it is ready to transfer another byte. The TI bit is raised at the beginning of stop bit. At the beginning of stop bit. What I told you here, 8 bits of data we will transfer followed by stop bit. Am I correct? The 8 bits of data transfer will be completed. The stop bit will go, means then TI will raise. Means from my side, I completed my task and now I am ready to transfer another set of data. Any confusion? Same way RI. RI, when 8051 receives data serially, it gets rid of the start and stop bits and places the byte in the SBUF register. I'll explain what is that. Then it raises the RI flag to indicate that a byte has been received and should be picked up before it blasts. And RN is raised halfway through the stop bit. Any confusion in this concept? Clear? Okay. S-buffer. S-buffer means serial buffer register. This is one of the register which is related to serial communication, which is used to store the data. It is only for storage purpose. It's only for storage purpose. Clear? Okay. So now, first we will come complete how to calculate the baud rate and all we will discuss, okay, in serial communication. Now you know how to, what is baud rate? Now we have studied about what is communication, what are the types of communication, serial, parallel, again what are the types of serial communication, simplex, half duplex, full duplex, understand? And what are the pins associated to serial communication, TXD and RXD, and that is in which port, port 3, 0 pin and first pin, and how to do the interfacing with the help of MAX232 and RS232, which is another name is DB9 connector. And what is, and complete serial communication is controlled with the help of SCON register, which is of 8 bit, and we have studied clearly about SCON register. Now we will discuss about the baud rate. What is baud rate? Anyone please define what is baud rate? Simple way. It's okay if it is incorrect also, no problem. Just try to. What is baud rate? Without knowing the, now I am going to explain you how to calculate the baud rate. Baud rate calculation I am going to explain you. But at least you should know now what is baud rate. It's okay, just give me the answer. What is baud rate? What is baud rate? Rate of per bit. Data transfer rate. How much speed we are, the data is transferring from source to destination. Data transfer rate. Units are BPS. Okay, baud per second or bits per second. So that is baud rate. So you are transferring the data, and serial communication we are using, we have studied that. But now we have to calculate the baud rate also. Okay? Okay. Before going to calculate the baud rate, again I am asking the basic things. You know how to do the calculation? No. What is the oscillator frequency in 8051 microcontroller? Default oscillator frequency which we are using? 11.0592 megahertz. Simply we will call it as machine cycle frequency. Okay, we have to calculate the machine cycle frequency. From machine cycle frequency, then finally we have to calculate the baud rate. That I will explain. Okay, so crystal oscillator is, frequency is 11.0592 megahertz. Okay.
Calling it as
machine cycle frequency. Now again I will divide this machine cycle frequency by 32. Divide by 32, then I will get the value to set the baud rate. Again I am asking you one question. Why to divide by 32? Serial communication. How many ports are there? Each port is of how many bit? 18 to 4. And all ports are used as bidirectional input output, means to read the data and to write the data, means communication. Yes or no? That is the reason we are dividing it by 32. Tell me the answer. Divide it and tell me. 28,800. Am I correct? 28,000. Is it incorrect? Okay, units cars, very good. Is it correct? This is the value to set the baud rate. This is the value to set the baud rate. Any confusion in this? What are the steps now? Crystal oscillator. Divide by 12. We will get machine cycle frequency. Machine cycle frequency divided by 32, we will get the value to set the baud rate. So how much is the crystal oscillator frequency? 11.0592 megahertz. Understand why we are dividing it by 12? To execute a single instruction in 8051 microcontroller, how many clock cycles needed? 12. So crystal oscillator frequency divided by 12 gives machine cycle frequency, that is nothing but 92.91.6 kilohertz. Then we are dividing it by 32. Why 32? Four ports are there, each port is of 8 bit, 8 into 4, 32, because all four ports are used as bidirectional input output port. And we are getting the value 28,800 hertz. This is the value to set the baud rate. Now again we will discuss how to set the baud rate using this value. Any confusion up to this? Are you clear? Okay. Now I want to set the baud rate of 9600. For my communication, I am using the baud rate of 9600. Now this is the value to set the baud rate. Am I correct? Now tell me, to get 9600, how many times I have to divide this? 28,800 divided by? Multiply by 32. Divide by? Both you can do. You can do it in hexadecimal, decimal. See here I have done in decimal. You can do it in hexadecimal. Whatever the procedure. Now, if you divide it by minus 6. Okay, forget about minus. If you divide it by 6, how much you will get? 28,800 divided by 6. How much you will get? 4,800? Yes or no? Say yes. Divide by 6. So that is the reason we are adding minus 6. You can convert this value in hexadecimal. You know you are good in digital electronics. Try to do that conversions. Okay? Understand? So to set, suppose 9600. So how many times? Divide by 12. Divide by 12. Is it correct? 28,800 divided by 12, how much? 2000, okay. If you want to set 9600 baud rate, we have to divide by 3. Am I correct? Yes or no? Please respond. Yes. Understand? So as per our requirement, how much baud rate we have to set? So you have to use this value. baud rate. To set the baud rate. Any confusion in this procedure? Confident? So now can I explain the program? Okay.
Say confidently.
Okay. So here my question is, I just assumed that we are taking the baud rate. Okay, we will consider the baud rate of 9600. So I am entering the value 3. In which timer? No. Which timer? 1 or 0? 1. Why 1? You understand? If you load the value in the TH1, the same value will be uploaded into TH0. Because which mode we have selected? Auto reload mode. We have selected auto reload mode. Suppose if you have selected 16-bit timer, you have to load the value in the higher byte of the timer as well as lower byte of the timer. Understand? Are you clear? Okay. Next, you understand SCON? What is the meaning of this? We have made it TI is equal to 0, RI is equal to 0 means initially we have to make it to start the transmission. Next, and we have opted asynchronous mode means 8 bit of data transfer which includes one stop bit, and we have enabled REN. And 3 bits we are not using, TB8, RB8 as well as SM2. That already I have explained you. Any confusion why we are loading 50H? Clear? Okay. Next. Which timer we are using here? 1 or 0? What I told you? You are setting which mode of operation, whether we are dealing with counter or timer, that we are going to enable with the help of T mode. But that particular timer again you have to enable, means timer 1 we are using. So what is TR1? Run control bit. That is available in TCON register. But TCON register is bit addressable, means you can access any single bit. No need to use complete TCON register, bit addressable. So we are using timer 1. So you have to enable the run control bit of timer 1. To enable, what is the instruction we are using here? Set B. B stands for bit. Set bit TR1. Means overall meaning is start the timer 1. Start the timer 1. So simply if you enable, timer will not start. You have to particularly enable the run control bit of the particular timer which we are using. Clear? Any confusion? Okay. Now what I told you? Now what is our question? You have to transfer the letter A continuously. Simply, this is simple program. Okay, so here what is the register associated with serial communication? Serial buffer register. Serial buffer register. So whatever the data I want to transfer, that I am entering into the serial buffer register. And what is this? And same data has to transmitted to receiver. Again same data. A has to transfer continuously. So what we have to check, whether the transmission has completed or not, which indicates, how we will check the status whether our transmission is done or not? Not T1, TI. Yes, you are right, concept. TI is equals to 1 means previous data transmission was done successfully and it is like raising the interrupt that I am ready to transfer another byte of data. Understand? So we have to check the status of TI. If TI bit is equal to, not equal to 1, we are not allowed to transfer another byte of data. That is the reason what we are using here, jump. If TI bit is not is equal to, not is equal to 1. Understand? So if TI status is equal to 1 means data transfer is done. If TI bit is not equal to 1 means the same data will be transferred continuously. Once you have to check the status of TI. If TI is equal to Any confusion? Clear TI. S-jump again. Why we are, S-jump means short jump. Why we are doing this means, our question is not one time continuous. But continuously in the sense, but still you have to check the status of TI. If TI raises the interrupt means transmission has done. Then only you can transfer another byte of data. If TI is equal to 0 means you cannot do any transfer because that indicates that already transfer is going on. Transferring of data is in process. Clear? This is a simple program. So if you understand this, now you can transfer. Transfer Trisomy College. R-A-S-O. How many characters are there? Can you transfer the complete message? Just try it. Okay, University of Pune. This kind of questions you will get in the final exam. Clear? Any confusion? So if you are studying the concept, you have to remember the sequence. Don't blindly study it. While studying, you have to analyze how you have to write the coding. Without that, blindly you cannot mug up the code. Okay? At least SC level, you should be in a position to analyze the code. Maybe if you are not able to write in your own, but at least you should be able to analyze the code. If you are clear with the theory concept, it is not at all difficult to analyze the code. Any confusion? Clear? Okay.